For more on this, we say hello to Marc Denis. Marc, this news coming down over the course of this show, what can you tell us about what led Carey Price to that decision not to play and opting to rest?
A nagging injury for Carey Price. He said, just coming back from missing the last three-game road trip for the Montreal Canadiens, that it's been nagging him for 7 weeks, a lower body injury that kept him out of the games in Florida, Tampa, and Dallas right as the new year was turning. He has been back and healthy and playing really well. Got a shutout in his first game back here at home at the Bell Center against the Vancouver Canucks. Maybe not so well against the Nashville Predators, but you can't pin the loss on him. He's really found his bearings. He's back to elite status, being in top five in most statistical categories in December. This is a Carey Price of old, but because of this injury, he's elected not to go to the All-Star game. In all truth and being honest, I'm not sure he was deserving of the All-Star nod. And that injury just confirmed, with Mark Bergevin coming back today from the World Junior Championships, he had a chance to sit down with a general manager, the medical staff, and decide on the path. And the path that makes the more sense for this hockey team is to have Carey Price healthy and rested. Montreal only plays on the 23rd here against Arizona, and then a back-to-back on Super Bowl weekend, this February 2nd and 3rd at home. He'll miss one of February 2nd or January 23rd game.
And I guess time will tell which of those games the Habs choose that he will sit out. But the Habs very much in the mix in terms of the playoff picture, but on the outside of that picture, looking in for the first time this season. Is there any extra emphasis on tonight's game for this team?
Well, tonight's game is obviously of the utmost importance for the standings. Montreal, Jackie's looking from the outside of the playoff picture for the first time since the regular season has started, beating just about everybody's expectations. I don't think they should emphasize too much on where they're sitting at. Right now, they have a comfortable lead in the teams behind them. They are in the thick of the battle, and it took half a season for the top teams in the Eastern Conference to really get to the top three places or standing spots in their division. Montreal will be in the battle until game 82, most likely, to find the spot in the playoffs, and they can't emphasize only one game. But the Minnesota Wild visiting tonight here at the Bell Center, they're a little bit in the same situation on the outside looking in, but very close to a playoff spot in the Western Conference.
Well, Shea Weber has certainly made an impact for the Habs since returning from that offseason knee surgery. How important has he been for Montreal and for Montreal to have their captain back in the lineup?
He's been instrumental to the success of this team. This was a 500 hockey team, winning a game and losing one. Since he's been back on November 27th, the 33-year-old hasn't missed a beat. Although he's missed, practically a full year of hockey. 25 minutes and over, he's played in the first game he was back and hasn't really backed down since. What Shea Weber really brings to this defensive group is everybody's now in their own spot. Jeff Petrie, playing 20 to 23 minutes, has been on the score sheet on a regular basis. Shea Weber is a force, we all know, and the right side is really being stabilized. Between Petrie and Weber, you're going to find 50 quality minutes of ice time for a defenseman. Now, the left side remains to be seen what Marc Bergevin will look to do, because there may be some upgrades available.
Well, on the other side of the ice tonight is Zach Parise, a guy who's dealt with his own injuries over the last couple of seasons. But this year, he is healthy, and he's been producing big for the Minnesota Wild. How will the Habs look to slow him down tonight?
They'll obviously have the Parise, Coyle, and Cunningham line. They are going to keep a close eye on it. I'd anticipate Shea Weber to have that matchup, that tough matchup tonight. That line has been on fire, accounting for 50% of the offensive production of the whole Minnesota Wild team for the last four games since they've been together. Coyle is a big center iceman, we all know that. But with Parise being healthy, he's riding a three-game goal streak right now. He seems to be very clutch. He seems to find a way to help his team get points in the standings. He was good in the game against Ottawa, the last one here for the Minnesota Wild. Dubnyk and he were the two main reasons why Minnesota Wild is coming here with a win on the road.
Well, the Habs sitting just outside of the playoff picture heading into tonight's action. A big 2 points on the line against the Minnesota Wild. Thanks for this. We appreciate it.